One of the things I'm enjoying most after only two episodes of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier is that the show isn't shying away from something important. That no matter how much good he does in service of his country as a soldier and as a superhero, in the end, Sam Wilson is still a black man in America. In episode one, Sam and James Rhodes walk through the new Captain America Memorial at the Smithsonian. Rhodey asks Sam why he gave up the shield that Steve Rogers gave him at the end of Avengers Endgame. Why did he reject the mantle of Captain America? It's obvious that Sam doesn't think he can live up to the legacy Steve Rogers left behind. White, black, brown, red, or yellow, Steve Rogers was the best America had to offer. But is there another reason? Looking at all those images of Rogers' heroism, of Uncle Sam, of American patriotism, the one thing Sam Wilson does not see on display is a face that looks like his own. He might love his country. He has fought to defend its people and its ideals. But does America love him back? Would the powers that be accept his ownership of the shield or his taking up of the mantle of Captain America? Sam Wilson is still a black man in America. Deeper in that first episode, Sam and his sister try to get a loan to save their fishing trawler. The loan officer recognizes him, but isn't sure why. Maybe Sam played football at LSU. With a little prodding, the man recognizes Sam as the Falcon and immediately takes a photo. Then, woven amongst TMZ-level questions and a request for Sam to pose for a photo with him, the bank official casually denies the Wilsons a loan. Some of this is subtle. The loan officer thinks that if he recognizes Sam, it must be for one of a narrow selection of reasons. That list in the real world usually means something athletic or something in entertainment. More than a few rappers and pundits have expressed this sentiment over the years, but I like the way Killer Mike put it in the song Ric Flair. To make it out the ice cold streets of the city, you better have a Christopher Word game with it. You better have a dance game similar to Diddy, or play b-baller but a rim like Smitty, Josh, Chris, Bosh, Paul, Gasol, or any other nigga that ball and tall. I used to sell it white. Sam Wilson is still a black man in America. In episode two of the series, we meet Isaiah Bradley, an African-American soldier used as a test subject when the U.S. Army tried to recreate Dr. Erskine's super soldier formula after the World War II disappearance of Steve Rogers. Isaiah Bradley was the black Captain America, and by Bradley's own account, not even being Captain America protected him against the racism of the system. After his years of service, Bradley is further used as a guinea pig, presumably in an attempt to duplicate the fluke that created him, and he remains imprisoned for 30 years. Bradley's time as America's super soldier has been kept a secret from the world. Bucky only knows him because he lost a one-on-one fight to Bradley during the Korean War. Isaiah Bradley's life echoes more than one of the blights on American history, including the Tuskegee syphilis experiment, the Buffalo Soldiers, and of course, slavery itself. Isaiah Bradley was Captain America, but he was also still just a black man in America. Leaving Bradley's home, Sam and Bucky argue about the secret of the black cap. They are stopped by the Baltimore police, who focus on Sam, a black man raising his voice to a white man on the street in broad daylight. The cop becomes confrontational with Sam. Only after Bucky's intervention, a challenge of, "Do you know who he is?" does the officer relent. Sam is lucky that he had a white friend to vouch for him. Fame isn't always enough to prevent a black man from being harassed by the cops in America. The same can be said for real-life black men, like NBA player Sterling Brown, assaulted by Milwaukee police after parking improperly in front of a store.
Taser! Taser! Taser!
Or East Illinois University swimmer Jalen Butler, assaulted by police who thought he was holding his teammates hostage when they stopped on the way home from a swim meet to stretch their legs and take a group photo. there are 4 more episodes to this series. I hope Sam Wilson finds the self-confidence to take back what is rightfully his, to accept the mantle of Captain America as bestowed on him by his friend Steve Rogers. I want Sam to be Captain America. Steve Rogers wanted Sam to be Captain America. Hell, even Bucky wants Sam to be Captain America. But even if he does become Captain America, the fight is not over. Sam Wilson will still be a black man in America.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now.